about the spirit of abuse. What about in the spiritual world? There's a demon, there's a spirit, there's a spirit. And we are the ministers, we gotta pray this thing off of you. We gotta declare you free. You got the Son of Man set free, it's free indeed. But the spirit won't take it away. The spirit won't move. As many as are led by the spirit of God, those are sons of God. Few more scriptures. Oh my God, we're gonna feel some power in this place tonight. Can the church have power? Some shaking is in the ground. Some refreshing of the spirit. Some rededication. Hallelujah. I don't want to be just going through the motions. I want the real thing. I don't want a form of godliness that denies the power of God. Keep it power. I want that. A few more scriptures, we're going to pray. Oh, I feel the witness in my spirit. I got about a shot out of this. Oh Lord, in the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 10. My God, I feel like shouting right now. Oh my God, hallelujah. Oh my God, it's the spirit. The spirit. Paul said, let me read the scripture. Ephesians chapter 6. I'm going to start at verse 10. It says, finally. When there's a finally, that means you're at the end of something. Something finna close. Huh? You're at the end of the day. It's a finally. We've been through the whole thing. You've been through this and you've been there, but finally. It's going to be a finally in your life one day. It's going to be a finally. You're going to go to the graveyard, but you're not coming back. I do the graveside service. Amen. I say ashes to ashes and dust to dust. I do all of that. I leave the family. I'm leaving it with Jesus. I'm leaving it in the hand of the Lord. Tell the folk, call the family. Make sure it's all right. And when everything is done, I turn it over to the undertakers. And you know when it's time, for the, you know what? I'm out of there. But I know one day I'm going to go there and I'm not going to leave. It ain't that end of your story. This is just a test. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. Weeping will it go for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. This too shall pass.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Mr. Grant, I'm going.
Touch somebody and say, be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord. If you preach the power of God, people are going to be strong. You sin, I sin, everybody sin. Stop making excuses for people sin. And you living so holy, they got to live holy just like you. They got to give it all up just like you. Every sin, every weight that told you to beset you, I had to give it up. If you want everything God wants God for you, you got to give it up. When I came to God, they say you got to give it up. You got to give it up. You got to give it all up. Now that sex got a stronghold on you. My God, that thing will get a stronghold on you. You is an infant. You can't even how to stand up. I need stop your lying. Lust got you. You can't even perform that. You know, Abraham was dead. Sarah was dead. But that was a move of God. How many know some things come with age? It is what it is. Old person talking about, yeah, little women, they love it. No, they love your money. That's what you give it up. Let me move on. Don't y'all throw nothing up here. I'm almost finished. But some of these sisters got some heavy purses. Some of them packing heat too. How many know it's right? He said, be strong in yourself.
In the Lord.
In the Lord.
Be strong in your thoughts.
In the Lord.
In your doctrine.
In the Lord.
See that? Some folk got their own doctrine. They don't have Jesus' doctrine. They got their own doctrine. They want to make you go along with it. I'm not going along with that lie. I ain't playing church. I got up at a funeral, I blew that thing up. All this shacking, it won't mean to accept you like everybody else. And it was one of my wife's relatives. I said, Sister Diane, stand up. I said, see that lady right there? I'm married to her. If you want to get in this family, come through the front door. And stop coming through the back door. And coming through the window. He made me mad. And? And what? How many of we need some holy bones? You gotta preach the truth. I don't care if the whole church get them walk out on. When God see that standard in you, it'll never be empty. You hear me? Because I said within myself, I'm preaching so folks are leaving. I said, if you get out of the five, I'm going to go hook up with somebody. It never got that low. In fact, you know, it's a turnover. You know, you understand people come and go. They come and go. But as they left, others came. Folk got out the choir. Ain't nobody in the choir no more. I said, yeah, because y'all don't want to be. And then God just kept on doing. You got to understand, this is God's work. We're just soldiers in the army of the Lord. So he said, be strong. Look at somebody and said, be strong.
Be strong.
He didn't say, do the best you can. He said, you can't even destroy a strong man's house. You got to bind him first. You can't destroy that man's house. You got to bind him first. He said, be strong in the Lord. And in the power, not your might, his might. Do you know God represents power? Do you know the Spirit of God is more than a la 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 ba 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 shiko? Yeah, his tongue, but what else? Power to cast out devils. You can't cast out a devil if you ain't got no Holy Ghost. They'll run you all over Chicago. Run you from Illinois back to Texas. Y'all read in the Bible, come out in the name of Jesus, who Paul preached. See, Paul knows something, but you don't know nothing. Jesus I know, and Paul I know, but who are you? The devil know who you are when you got the Holy Ghost. The devil know who you are when you got power in your life. The power of his life. Put on the whole armor. Anybody receiving me today? Put on the whole armor of God. You can't just say, I got what I got, my shield. That's just to quench. Well, I got my feet. Well, that's good too. Well, I got my helmet. Some folk ain't got no helmet on. They too tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine. Got nothing on, no breastplate on. Do Uncle Sam send folks off the wall like that?
No.
The longer you live, the more you can do to the enemy. Do y'all see that in the spirit world?
Yeah.
The longer you live, the more you can put in some on the enemy. Then he said, above all, take the shield of faith.
That's right.
Wherewith you may quench. I mean, the shield of faith to quench, but the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God.
Yeah.
Honey, you got to swing that thing. Hey, you're going to have to be Zorro. Remember Zorro, you got some Z's and people. You got to get skilled with that sword. That represents your office. Somebody got this, it ain't nothing for your back, no way. What you running from now? Run from church to church. Relationship to the relationship. Is with an L-E-N. Look what the word of God says. I'm almost finished here.
Take your time.
He said, for we wrestle not against, no, put on the whole armor of God that you might stand against the wiles of the devil. See, the devil got wiles. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. I heard the minister saying that earlier about that flesh. That flesh. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. Listen to this. Against powers. Against spirit rulers of darkness of this world. Against the spiritual wickedness in high